Hi, and welcome to the Math Review. In this lesson, we're going to go over how to divide whole numbers, also known as long division. We'll go over this example here. I'll make sure I go nice and slow, step by step. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. We love to help. I hope you're ready, because here we go. So here's our question. 3,152 divided by 8. And even though this is the question, we can't do any of these steps until we write it in long division notation. So let's do that. But before we can even do that, we need to know which numbers are dividend and which is our divisor. In this notation, the dividend is the first number. So that's this number here, 3,152. Which means that this 8 has to be our divisor. Since our dividend is 3,152, when we're writing it in long division notation, and that's what's getting divided, it goes inside the notation. So let's put that here. And this means that our divisor 8 has to be outside this long division notation. And what I like to do is I like to make sure that we split up our columns. And this is to make sure that we're dividing the right values that we need to. Now, let's get started. Step number one, we're going to divide. Well, what exactly are we going to try to divide? We always start at the front of our dividend. Well, can 8 go into 3? Well, no, it can't. So instead, what we're going to try is to divide 31. Can 8 go into 31? Well, yeah. How many times can that happen? That would be 3. And remember, you're always going to put the answer you write on top right above the rightmost column of the number you're dividing. That means we're not putting the number 3 here. We're putting it above this number to the right. We're dividing 31. 1's on the right, we put the number above that. That brings us to step 2, which is to multiply. And we're just multiplying 3 times 8, because that's going to give us 24. Then I'll subtract. 31 minus 24 is going to give us 7. Then we'll go to step 4, which is to bring down. But what exactly are we bringing down? Well, for that, we're going to need to look to the column to the right. Right now, we're here, and that means the column to the right is this column here, the 5. So this 5 has to get brought down next to the 7. That gives us the number 75, and that's where we're going to start repeating our process. So we're going to divide 75 by 8. And how many times can 8 go into 75? Well, that would be 9, because when we multiply 9 times 8, we get 72. Since we finished multiplying, now we just have to subtract. 75 minus 72 will give us 3. And next, we'll bring down what's in our column to the right. In this case, that's 2. So we're going to bring that 2 down. And that's going to give us our new number here, which is 32. And then we repeat the process. So let's divide 32 by 8. How many times can 8 go into 32? Well, that would be 4 times. Because when we multiply 4 times 8, that gives us 32. Then we'll subtract. 32 minus 32 will give us 0. Now this 0 remainder at the end is very important, because that's the sign that we're done, as long as we don't have any more numbers in the column to the right. And since that's the case here, we're done. Our final answer is 394. You could also say the quotient of 3,152 and 8 is 394.